Hi, I'm Yiting from CISPA. Now I'm presenting our work named On the Evolution of Hateful Memes by Means of Multimodal Contrastive Learning. This is a joint work with my collaborators Xinlei, Shannon, Pierson, Savvas, Zannettou, and my advisor Michael Bacchus and Yang Zhang. Before this talk, I'd like to warn the content and imagery in this talk might be offensive. So, what is a meme? Meme is defined as an image or catchphrase that spread online to express one's ideology. Most users create and spread them for making fun purpose. However, some malicious users create hateful memes to spread online hate, including white supremacy, anti-Semitism, and Muslim phobia. These hateful memes sometimes can be weaponized in the real world to attack a certain people or a group. So they're posing a great threat to online safety these days. But detecting hateful memes is not an easy task. On the one hand, memes naturally are multimodal products. They often appear under different textual contexts. So to fully understand memes, we need to take into account not only the images, but also their different contexts. On the other hand, hateful memes have an evolutionary nature that can constantly evolve into new variants that can escape the detection. Dealing with these challenges, multimodal contrastive learning offers a new solution. We use OpenAI's CLIP in this work. To train a CLIP model, we need to collect many image text pairs. We feed these pairs into different encoders and get the image embedding and text embeddings. We compute the cosine similarity of image embeddings and text embeddings and maximize them if they're from the same pair. By doing this, embeddings from different modalities are aligned together and projected into the same space. In this paper, we use Fortune dataset, which contains 12.5 million image text pairs, to fine-tune OpenAI's CLIP model. With the output embeddings, we find that semantics can be transferred across image embeddings and text embeddings. For instance, we add the image embedding of Happy Merchant on the text embedding of Donald Trump. And we use the fuse embedding to compare with all image embeddings in our dataset. We found the top one closest to image embedding happens to be Trump Merchant. This leads us to a new property on CLIP embeddings, semantic regularities. They originally appear in word-to-word vectors. It means the semantic relations between word vectors, such as the king and queen example. In our work, we find that semantics can be transferred between image embeddings and between image and text embeddings. Following the terminology of word-to-word, we named the semantic relations as visual semantic regularities, visual linguistic semantic regularities. So this property seems to provide us a new view to identify the variants of hateful memes. We start with visual semantic regularities. Assume we have a known hateful meme, such as Happy Merchant. How can we identify the hateful meme variants, such as Trump Merchant? And can we even estimate the imagery influencer, like Donald Trump's picture in this case? To do this, we first take the image embedding of this hateful meme, and then we compute cosine similarities between this particular embedding and every image embedding in our Fortune dataset. We then identify a threshold range manually. And if the cosine similarity is in this range, we consider the image as potential variant. Now, given the potential variant, we use the variant embedding minus the known hateful meme embedding and compute the cosine similarities between this embedding and all image embeddings in our dataset. We again select the image who has the highest similarity. And if the similarity value is larger than a threshold, we then consider this image as a potential imagery influencer. We apply this pipeline using the Happy Merchant as the case study, and we identified more than 3,000 variant influencer pairs. As Fortune dataset does not contain ground truth labels, we perform manual annotations on a randomly sampled 100 pairs to evaluate the performance. And we found that 78% of the identified variants and 53% of the influencers are correctly identified. Here is the visualization of some variant influencer pairs. To check the prevalence of different variants, we built a graph with variants or influencers as nodes and their pairing relations as edges. We apply community detection techniques to divide them into different communities. Each community is a bunch of similar variant influencer pairs. This figure shows top 20 communities, and we represent each community with a variant and influencer pair. We can see that for every pair, variant on the left just looks like the combination of the influencer on the right and the original happy merchant. Now, what if we want a more precise detection? For example, we have this known hateful meme happy merchant, and we wonder if we can find Trump merchant directly by specifying the word Donald Trump as the textual influencer. In this scenario, we use visual linguistic semantic regularities. We first collect a set of named entities from Fortune dataset from four categories, including geopolitical entities, person, nationalities, religions, and organizations. Taking one entity as a textual influencer, we fuse the text embedding of this entity and the image embedding of Happy Merchant. And then we run a similar process as the first pipeline to get the identified variant. We apply this pipeline on 120 entities from four categories. For each category, we collect top 30 most frequent entities from the post in the Fortune dataset. Here are some examples of the identified variants. The entity is shown in the above of each variant. By annotating all the variants, we found a 76% to 80% of the geopolitical and nationality entities have the corresponding variants, which indicates Happy Merchant is prone to be fused with countries, nationalities, and religions. We also find that more than 40% of the entities about political figures and organizations also have the corresponding variants. So far, we've seen how semantic regularities can be applied to study the hateful meme evolution. Actually, with clip embeddings, we can do more than evolution. Knowing that fused embeddings contain both the semantics from images and text, we can use the fused embedding for a series of downstream analysis. For instance, we can retrieve the closest image or the text in the dataset. And then with the retrieved text, we can extract the key phrase or measure the hate score within the text using tools such as Google's Perspective. Because the images and the text share the same semantics, we can use this key phrase or hit scores to represent and explain the retrieved images. Combining them with clustering techniques, we can group millions of Fortune data into clusters. And each cluster is annotated automatically with a key phrase and a hit score. By ranking these hit scores, we can summarize the main targets of hateful content appeared with Fortune memes and find out those highly hateful clusters. Finally, to summarize the paper, we perform a systematic analysis on the evolution of hateful memes using semantic regularities. And we identified more than 3,000 variant imagery influencer pairs of Happy Merchant. We also found that some variants are easily linked to politicians, countries, nationalities, and organizations. We also demonstrate that hateful memes can be studied in a multimodal view, such as identifying the targets of hateful content, which help us better understand the meme ecosystem. Finally, we envision our framework to be a supportive tool to help platform moderators and report hateful memes and track new variants of hateful memes. Especially in coordinated hate campaigns, our work can quickly identify the main targets of hateful content and report highly hateful meme clusters. That's all about our work. I'd like to acknowledge the contribution of my co-authors and a special thank to Google's Perspective and Rewire for providing their APIs to detect hateful content. Thank you for your attention.